Hello, welcome back. I'm Statman Dave, and today we're going to be discussing why Cristiano Ronaldo makes Manchester United into Champions League contenders. Remember to subscribe if you're new, smash that like button, and come and check us out on Twitch where we stream Monday to Friday at 11 a.m. But anyway, let's get this party started. Cristiano Ronaldo wasted little time getting amongst the goals on his return to Old Trafford. Whilst the club icon has made it known he expects to win the Premier League, I think the transfer makes United genuine contenders for the Champions League. So today, I'm going to explain why. Even without Cristiano Ronaldo, I would have expected Manchester United to perform better in this season's Champions League. Ignoring the strength of the group's Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has had an extra year of Champions League experience. Add this extra experience to a solid game plan and Ollie's side will be far more competitive. However, Solskjaer's tactics will be supercharged with the addition of Ronaldo. The Champions League is also the competition that gets the best out of the Portuguese international. His list of records in the competition is just silly. Most goals in the Champions League, most goals in a single season, most goals in the knockout stages, most wins in finals, and he's the only player in the competition to score in 3 separate finals, score in all 6 group games, and to score in 11 straight Champions League games. And he's not slowing down either. With 16 goals in 23 Champions League games for Juventus, Ronaldo is a machine in this competition. Solskjaer, meanwhile, has a good record in big games as Manchester United manager, where his counter-attacking tactics thrive, highlighted by the fact that he's lost less than 30% of his Premier League games against the Big Six. Add Ronaldo into this equation, one of the best big game players in the world, and Manchester United will be even more dangerous in these encounters. But where Solskjaer has struggled when facing deep set low blocks, Ronaldo's aggressive goal scoring movement will win more matches. Take his opener against Newcastle. After a scramble, Pogba is in possession. He works it wide to Greenwood, who runs at the defender, before cutting inside and getting a shot off. His shot is spilled and Ronaldo's there to tap it in. On the surface, this looks like a fortunate goal that just fell to the number 7, but Ronaldo has made his own luck. When Greenwood receives wide, Ronaldo asks for the ball to the back post and holds his position, but as Greenwood shapes the shoot, Ronaldo's the only player on the move as he can react to the mistake. As it happens, the keeper can't hold Greenwood's shot and Ronaldo opens the scoring. Being able to take the lead in games from moments like this will be a massive improvement to Manchester United and will feed into Solskjaer's best tactic, counter-attacking. Last season, a third of Manchester United's Champions League goals came from counter-attacking situations, with United winning 2 penalties, which were both converted from similar situations. Despite being 36 years old, Cristiano Ronaldo was the second fastest player on the pitch in his second Manchester United debut, which shows that he won't slow down Man United's counter-attacking. Ronaldo recorded this speed in his second goal of the game. After chasing a loose ball, Varane recovers possession. It goes long to Bruno Fernandes, who drops it back to Matic. Matic passes it to Pogba. Pogba passes it to Shaw as the left-back carries into the final third, slipping in Ronaldo, who finishes through the keeper's legs. Being able to rely on the counter-attack more will also benefit United's double pivot. Fred and Scott McTominay thrive in the counter-attacking style as their energy and work rate allows them to protect the defence and let the forwards take up positions higher up the pitch, which suits the transition. This ball-winning blend is superb for bigger games, or even when seeing out results, but Ronaldo's goal scoring can actually make another player work in that role. Paul Pogba's arguably United's standout player this season, with 7 assists after just 4 games. He's got nearly twice as many assists as the next best player across Europe's top 5 leagues. Most of this good work has come when Pogba has played in a more advanced position on the left wing, where the likes of Fred and McTominay can provide the pivot and provide that solid base in midfield. When Pogba has played a little bit deeper, we've seen the Frenchman get caught out defensively at times, which outweighs the extra attacking output you get from United's number 6. However, with Ronaldo in the starting 11, who's going to put chances away, Solskjaer can deploy Pogba deeper and get in an extra attacker as he looks to outscore the opposition. Lingard's goal against Newcastle wouldn't have been possible without Pogba in a deeper position, as United have got 5 players in the box as Lingard finishes, but still had 2 playmakers in Shaw and Pogba on the edge. Whilst in the latter stage of the competition, Pogba can be played on the flanks, giving United a bit more defensive protection and control from a 4th midfielder while still getting his creativity as he drifts into number 10. Manchester United's summer transfer window was nothing short of spectacular. all three major signings addressing problem positions in United's squad and have brought a bit of sparkle to the side. United's squad as a whole has lacked leadership and trophy-winning experience, things that the new boys, Rafael Varane and Cristiano Ronaldo, have in abundance. The duo won four Champions Leagues together, with Varane keeping things tight at the back and letting Ronaldo's goals win matches. We've already seen the former Real Madrid man leading the dressing room, with Varane instructing Wan-Bissaka against Wolves, and Ronaldo inspiring confidence in his pre-match speech against Newcastle. The all-time top scorer in the competition, the Champions League, is Ronaldo's. Alone, he puts the side in contention with the competition, we saw with an unimpressive and ageing Juve. But when you add his talents to a side on the up, how can Man United not be expected to be Champions League contenders? But anyway guys, what do you think? Does Cristiano Ronaldo make Man United Champions League contenders? Let me know in the comments below. Give me your predictions. Who's going to win the tournament? I've been Statman Dave. Subscribe if you're new. We'll see you later. Thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, why not check out some more content on the Statman Dave YouTube channel?